What's up, Muscle and Strength? I'm Scott Herman, Team BSN, and today we're going to be talking about which is the better muscle builder, cable crossovers or dumbbell flies. But before I get into each exercise, I want you guys to first understand the flex and stretch portion of each movement. Now, both exercises follow the same movement pattern, which is starting here and ending here. But what is the significance of that? Well, for those of you guys who have a harder time with mind-muscle connection, maybe you don't feel your chest activate as much on other chest exercises, including these two, being able to focus on that hard flex at the top of the movement right here is gonna help teach you to flex your chest and increase that mind-muscle connection to make any chest exercise you do a bit more effective. Now, what happens during the negative and at the bottom of the movement? Well, you build the most muscle, or you get the most muscle damage for regrowth during the negative, and also when you sit in that stretch at the bottom of every single repetition. So, what does that mean when it comes to cable crossovers or dumbbell flies? Well, for those of you guys who have a harder time with that mind-muscle connection and you need to work on that flex, you're better off incorporating the cable crossovers into your training routine, because with the cable crossover, you have constant resistance being placed on your chest, whether at the bottom of the movement or at the top where your hands are together. And when your hands are together at the top of the movement, you're gonna be able to really flex and squeeze your chest while resistance is placed on those cables, versus when utilizing the dumbbell chest fly, when your hands are at the top of the movement, yeah, there's resistance from holding the weight in the air, but in terms of resistance on your chest while it's flexed, it's not gonna be nearly as much as it is when doing the cable crossover. However, when you go to the bottom of the movement and you're trying to fight the negative and you're trying to hold as much weight as possible during the stretch portion for even more muscle damage for regrowth, obviously the dumbbells are gonna be far more superior, and it's for a couple different reasons. Number one, you'll be able to control and handle a lot more weight during that negative. And number two, when you're at the bottom of a chest fly with dumbbells, your shoulders are not going to be placed in a compromised position as long as your shoulders are packed and your back is arched. When utilizing a cable crossover, sometimes the cables can kind of pull your shoulders out of being packed and actually pull them up. So when you're at the beginning of that movement, your arms are more in a position where your shoulders are compromised because they're starting to raise up a bit. And that's just gonna happen because of the range of motion of the movement. In terms of your workout, what should you be focusing on? For those of you who need to hit more mind-muscle connection, choose the cable crossovers. For those of you guys who have pretty good mind-muscle connection and you wanna focus on overloading and maximizing muscle damage, definitely go for those dumbbell chest flies. Hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.